So even though it's a narrow pull, her arms are on fire. I try to get her to go out farther. She's more interested in doing what that clock needs to say, and I'm okay with that. She's got 2 more minutes of this. She gets 15 minutes now to do whatever she wants. That's my deal with her. Because what happens is on critical velocity is you get to about 28, 30 minutes and you're done. You don't want to do anymore. And so what you tell yourself, look, I get a whole 15 minutes at the end if I just make this. And the shift of critical velocity almost always shifts the 200 and 100 breaststroke, so, or whatever stroke you're doing. So it doesn't always. Sometimes they can't hold a stroke. Sometimes they're not very good with lactate tolerance, which she's not really getting lactate tolerance here. Sometimes they don't have enough speed in order to be better. Or maybe they're already aerobically fit. But when you see a shift in this, let's say she started the season with 150s, now she's at 140s. Yeah, she feels a whole lot better at that seventh lap or that in meters in that third lap of the 200 breaststroke than she used to feel. And theoretically, she can come home with a lot more gumption. She shifts the energy, and maybe she can't once she gets it too fast, or if she goes out too fast. And if we haven't worked enough lactate tolerance, then or lactate production, then she will have some trouble finishing that 200, no matter how fit she is for longer. So we have to be careful of that, but we track it all the time. We watch the stroke all the time. One more, huh? Okay, so this is her last one. I'm gonna compare that to her first one ever in this set. You'll see the same kick. That she had in the first lap, but she's gotten a really good EN2 workout here. We're happy with it. Could it be EN3? We don't think so, but could it have been on a tighter interval for EN2? Probably. I think she'd have made 130s, but yeah, it's hard to tell. And the way we tell is, let's say she goes 25 on 130 during the hour, then we know. You know, when we start to do that is we start to say, well, how many did you make in a row and how many did you make total? And then we try to go 26. And think about it, if you go out another 100 in an hour, you know, that's a nice drop. You go one more 100 yards in an hour of training, that's a good drop. It's not, you know, everything you want. You'd like to see that she can hold 135s or 130s or 125s or 120s. She can hold 120s. You know, she can start thinking about her 200 approaching 2 minutes. It won't be there. It won't be there unless she can go, you know, 50s on 26. If she can pop 50s on 26 and have a critical velocity of 210, of 120-ish or so, 115, then she has a shot to be thinking about breaking 2 minutes, which no one's ever done. All right. Good job. Get a pulse, please. And what's your RPE?
7.
7? Okay. The whole way?
Yeah.
Okay. No 100 was harder than another 100, right? Pretty much the same way?
Pretty much the same.
That's exactly how it's supposed to be.